LSU basketball season. We just played it for you.
That's terrible.
Shaq with the three-pointer. Shaq, Saturday.
One question. Where was that when LSU needed that in the tournament? Shaq, come on, big fella. That's awesome, though.
One three-pointer in his NBA career. One at the 26-year reunion of the 91 SEC title
game. That's awesome. That's awesome. Good for him. Good
How
for
about
him.
That, huh?
Yes, indeed.
I'd like to know when's the last time he shot a three-pointer prior to that moment. Was he in a dungeon earlier trying to rack it or over in the practice facility?
I doubt it. That's
probably
just,
not.
That's just Shaq being Shaq, baby. Awesome.
Tommy Chrystan and Jordy Hultberg, you got Tigers Roar. Yet another edition. And
turtleneck, huh?
Yeah, it's cold outside, man. I don't like this cold stuff.
Wow.
Well, we got to get right
to
the news.
You know why it's cold? Because baseball season's starting.
Yeah, that baseball and cold don't go together.
But it's going to happen.
Well, we have to start with football.
Okay.
Story that came out late this afternoon. Arden Key taking a leave from the Tiger football program for a personal matter. That's all that was said. All that's going to be said. Coach Orgeron asked everyone to respect the privacy of this personal matter. I've heard a dozen reasons why he has taken this leave. I'm not 100% certain that any of them are accurate, so we'll let it be rumors until something is proven. But
who cares?
Jordy, look, there's his numbers and his stats. He takes a leave of absence. It's been said that he will remain in school and that he is still a part of the football team. He hasn't left the program, but he is taking a break from football for personal reasons. Your thoughts?
Well, first of all, hopefully whatever the issue, the personal reason is, I hope they get it resolved quickly. I hope everything is okay. I've always felt like you have discipline within the confines of your team. You have organized times. You have to be certain places at certain times, and that tends to lead to discipline. I wonder why you're taking a leave of absence for a personal reason and getting away from that discipline. That's not for me to wonder why.
That's a good point.
But, I kind of goes against my thoughts and my principles on that. I always think if there's an issue, you want to be with your teammates, your coaches, because that's your discipline. That's your comfort zone. Now you get away from that. I don't know what the personal issue is, and maybe LSU's trying to help this young man with this personal issue.
So what you're saying, when you're with the team, there's more structure.
More structure,
you gotta
more discipline.
Right. You got to be in the meeting room at 9 o'clock, or you got to do this at 6 o'clock, and you got to do things.
Right. It occupies your time, takes away from the free time that you. That was the biggest adjustment I had to make in college. Instead of going to school from 8 in the morning till 3 in the afternoon, I went from 7:30 in the morning to 9:30 in the morning, and the rest of the day was off. So there's a lot of free time to do things, whereas within the structure of your program, you're in that locker room, you're in that weight room, you're in that meeting room, takes up time.
Couple of things, observations that I have. Number one, Arden Key, they know what he can do. They know what he's capable of. They know his skill set. They know how he fits as an outside end, defensive end, outside linebacker, whatever you want to call it. He's been under Aranda's system for a little bit. I don't think it's the worst situation in the world if you're Arden Key to miss spring practice. Now, spring football starts Saturday, March 11th. So it's conceivable. That's still right under a month away. It's conceivable, I guess, he could rejoin
at the appropriate time.
Yeah, it might be right before spring practice or might be during. But my point is, let's just say he misses the whole spring practice, the spring game on April 22, the whole bit. Then I don't think that's as bad as it might be for some players. They know him. He knows them. And the second point observation I'd like to make, this is going to give somebody else some reps. The reps that Arden Key won't get in the spring practices, the 15 workouts, will go to someone else, and maybe that player gets themselves better. Coaches notice and say, hey, that guy's maybe got a little more than we thought. It gives someone else an opportunity. So you try to find a silver lining there. Maybe some guy who wouldn't have got as many reps says, hey, coaches, I can handle this, and maybe they go with it. So I think that's all you can do, and as Coach Orgeron has asked, respect the privacy, and just tons of rumors flying around. There's some funny rumors. I'll say those.
Okay.
One started by me. I thought maybe he was going to be named head basketball coach at noon on Thursday, but wasn't a good one.
You shoot down Shaq?
Shoot down Shaq.
Yes, you did. Highlight of the you shot down the basketball program, and now you're doing it. Wow.
I got two down
Sam Spiegelman tweeted that, just for your information, for what it's worth, Arden Key has a child that's living in Atlanta, a little baby daughter.
Okay.
Or baby child. Mm-hmm. I don't know if it's son or daughter. So maybe there's something with that. I'm not here to try and dig up and disparage anything. You can be as negative as you want in a matter like this. I'm going to respect their privacy, and hopefully everything works out. He's got a brilliant future ahead of him if he can resolve whatever these personal problems are.
And, of course, this weekend, Boys from the Boot. It's a big mm-hmm. weekend for Louisiana football prospects to be on the campus of LSU. But, again, the story came out approximately 2 p.m. when the LSU communication office released it, that he would be taking that leave. And that's all we have for you on that. Obviously, find your favorite source if anything else develops or gets written or gets said or tweeted or Facebooked or whatever.
It's just human nature. People are going to think the worst.
Yeah. You know, and that goes back, you know, that said, is it the Buckley Act or the Buckley Amendment, which gives the guys privacy?
Sure.
I got in the longest discussion one night years ago with Herb Vincent. And of course, you know mm-hmm. Herb well, so do I. He's a big friend of the Pelicans. About that, shortly after this, I mean, this conversation is dang near 20 years ago. But I said, Herb, I said, and I finally got him to agree with me, that Buckley Amendment or the Buckley Act, which says they can't say why a kid's dismissed from a team or a girl, guy, whatever mm-hmm. team. I said, Herb, this is why that's bad. I understand the privacy, but when they don't say why, that fuels rumors and speculation, many of which could be false rumors and false speculation, which is incriminating to the student athlete, mm-hmm. when they just would say he flunked his three classes, he's not eligible.
You mean Leonard Fournette?
Well, if he just would say he flunked three classes,
you mean Leonard
then
Fournette?
You eliminate all the other rumors. And actually, Herb said he understood my point. But
well,
of course, he said
it is up to
the university
individual.
Must follow the,
right.
the law.
The individual can come out
and
say.
Yeah, the individual
it.
Can
if
say,
saying,
I flunked out of school.
Right, if somebody's saying something that's so far out in left field, then the individual has every right to go out and say, well, this is what happened.
Release it. Okay.
The school cannot. Right. Just like they can't give out grades and all that kind of stuff.
Oh, well, okay, whatever.
Southeastern didn't give out your grades.
And they were good at the end.
Yeah.
I was there a long time, though.
Yeah,
okay, like...
I got you.
Like,
what do we have coming up on the show?
No, this is fun. Every now and then, my father-in-law, the legendary Jack Salter, I'd be around him and a name would come up and I'd go, I went to school with that person at Southeastern. And he'd say, you went to school with a lot of people in Southeastern because
right.
you were there for 7.5 years. So I did go to school with a lot of people. All right, coming up on tonight's show, let's get back to pertinent matters here. We got some LSU football. We got an interview with Tommy Robinson, Mickey Joseph. They were formally introduced since we last got together with Tigers Roar. We want you to hear that. We're going to update you baseball, softball, gymnastics. We got plenty of stuff on all of that for you. Also tonight, the LSU Law School 13th Annual Barrister Bowl. We've talked about these folks before. These law school students.
Still chasing that
they
dream.
They play tackle football like cheerleaders. We have all that here tonight. We got video for you. We're going to have that in the program. We'll also hear from Brian Lazar of TigerBait.com. I'm sure he only has the information we have about Arden Key's leave from the team.
We got to talk about Brandon Harris leaving, too. That's interesting.
Well, Ronnie Rant, Sports Shorts Radio, Sports Shorts TV, and of course he's going to talk about baseball with that opening up and the Louisiana Sports Hall of Fame Foundation Glory Road Tour, which is in Baton Rouge Thursday night of this week at the Walk-Ons on Burbank. So plenty to come with that. And as you accurately said, Jordy, before we get the break, let's talk about Brandon Harrison. We actually have some of his numbers. I was a little surprised at the timing of this. Not that he's leaving,
right.
but the timing. Go ahead.
Something had to be said between the end of the semester and now. Something had to come across between the two parties because he said he was going to stick around and partake in this open quarterback competition. Now the big question, I'm not surprised he's left. He wants greener pastures. That's fine. Wish him well. What now comes into mind is Danny Etling's one hit away from being knocked out. You've got four other quarterbacks, only one has thrown a pass in a real game, and he's only thrown one. So you got Justin McMillan, Lindsey Scott Jr., you got Lowell Narcisse, who's on campus, going to school now, and you have Miles Brennan coming up. So it's a great opportunity for these young freshmen to step up, and if they can deliver, okay. But if not, quarterback issue is still going to be pertinent on the LSU football team. It's going to be the number one subject matter again.
And we'll get into that and a whole lot more tonight. Got plenty for you. We remind you, the original airing each week of this program, Wednesday nights, 8 p.m. to 10 p.m., 2 hours prime time. Where else are you going to get that? Cox Cable, AT&T, U-verse, digital tuners, the internet at PelicanSportsTV.com, and of course, Baton Rouge, Lafayette, and New Orleans. So that's what you have, Tigers Roar, and as we always say, spread the roar. This Saturday, the Pelican Sports Spring Post Game Show, 4:30, after the 2:30 contest between LSU and Bama over in Tuscaloosa. We'll take a break, come back, and let you hear from Coach Orgeron, his introduction of the two newest members to the the LSU football staff, and then a whole lot more coming. Stay right there. Jordy Hultberg, Tommy Chrisand. You're watching Tigers Roar. Pelican Sports TV. Stay with us.
Here at Rejuvenme Medical, we strive to accomplish a more youthful you. We specialize in the most advanced techniques of testosterone replacement therapy in men, bioidentical hormone replacement in women, IV therapy, and nutritional support, along with the state-of-the-art cosmetics procedures. Experience a network of trainers and health coaches offering diet and nutritional plans tailored to you. Call us today to schedule your free consultation to discuss your individual needs and goals. Look like you live. Live younger.
Creel Tree Service is a licensed and insured tree service providing tree and stump removal, topping, trimming, cabling, pruning, and fertilizing. We have free stump removal with takedowns, free estimates, affordable rates, and senior citizens discounts. Call 774-TREE. That's 774-8733. Get your yard ready for the warmer weather. If it deals with a tree, call me, Creel Tree Service. 774-8733. That's 774-TREE.
Perkins Road Veterinary Hospital is a full-service veterinary hospital committed to your pet's health. We offer advanced diagnostic and therapeutic medical services, laser surgery, dog and cat diets, and treats, along with stress-free boarding. Dr. Ritchie sees patients for routine checkups to keep your loved ones happy, also advanced medical and surgical cases. We have separate condos for cat boarding and large climate-controlled canine boarding. Our boarding dogs get to have fun in a very large play yard several times a day. Laser therapy is a service that we offer to heal wounds and help our patients that suffer from chronic pain. Laser therapy is a wonderful adjunct treatment for neurologic and arthritic pain with no side effects. Your pets are family members and deserve the best and highest quality of care. Dr. Ritchie and his staff greatly respect the human-animal bond and are committed to exceeding your expectations.
Cypress Lake Apartments are conveniently located off Segan Lane in Baton Rouge. Come see this community, which has many amenities including swimming pools, fitness room, playground, and much more. Beautiful views of Cypress Lake. 1, 2, 3-bedroom apartments are available. Stop by and see Cypress Lake Apartments. Give them a call at 225-293-6789 or visit online cypresslake-apartments.net.
Continue with Tigers Roar. Jordy Hultberg, Tommy Chrisand with you. Don't forget YouTube. Early on, about mid-morning Thursday, a program of its entire 2 hours will be on youtube.com/Pelican Broadcast, and you can watch it at your convenience. Jordy, as we always do, let's tell the folks about Tremonti's Meat and Seafood.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Crawfish season is upon us at 12451 Old Jefferson Highway. You can go to their website, Tremonti's.com. They have daily luncheon specials. They've got, rotisserie chickens every night. Those barbecue rotisserie ribs, which are just phenomenal. That's every Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Catering needs, you can go there, see the website. Take the phone number, 751-7665. And coming up in March, soon to be determined, they're going to have a once-in-a-lifetime meat sale on a Saturday where you will not believe the discounted prices on all their Chairman's Reserve beef and everything in-house. It's going to be a cannot-miss situation. We'll keep you informed on that as we get closer and the definite date is set. Stay tuned because that's going to be a great opportunity. You can buy in bulk and save it up and get all your tailgating needs for football season. Put it in the freezer and you're good to go. But boil crawfish every day and just call them, 751-7665. Get in line, get in the queue so they make sure they have enough for everyone.
Tremonti's.com, lots of information there as well. And you need to check it out. The wines, the high-end spirits, and so much money. It's so much. Like I always say, you go in there, you're going to be amazed at everything
really
that's
will.
In there. And get a little sprinkle spice. I'm about to have to go get some more. My son-in-law is addicted to it now. He's like, Pops, can you bring me some more when the next time you come? Yeah, we do that.
The Lenten season right around the corner. So
seafood
all the time. So. Great place to go. Really is.
All right. LSU football, Brandon Harris decides to transfer out. Arden Key taking a leave. But kind of lost in under the radar now is, since we were together last week, the formal announcement of two new assistant coaches on the staff. Now, let's keep in mind, it's been said many times, I'll say it right now, early April, the NCAA votes on a proposal to add a 10th full-time on-the-field paid assistant to all the D1 staffs, and
there has been an amendment to that now.
Oh!
Now they've said they on that resolution they may table that till January 2018, and the reason for that is a lot of schools already have their budgets in place. Some of these smaller schools are saying, "Whoa! We can't afford that right now. These other places are going to get a head start on us. Let's look for that to be pushed back."
Wow! It's
going to get passed. But it's not going to. I don't think it's going to get passed in April. I think it's going to come back in January.
I had a caller to the radio show the other day. This whole support staff thing.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, kind of started by Nick Saban.
Right.
All right. I did some research when the guy asked me on the radio. I didn't know a lot about it. I just knew a little bit about it. Jordy, this is a monster.
Oh.
You have schools that have 35 to 50. People on the support staff, former NFL front office guys, coaches, and they're breaking down film.
Mm-hmm.
They're evaluating talent and then going to the coaches who have to get it, and they're saying, look, here's the five guys you're not to see. We've been giving you a list of five, not a list of 50, because the rest we don't deem to be what you're looking for. And then all these, quality control and analyst positions.
Yep.
There's no guidelines as of yet by the NCAA as to how many you can have. The pay, this thing is, we saw LSU add a guy from the Saints, McMahon, a special teams guy.
Right.
And of course, Bobby April did a little special teams.
They're pale in comparison to other schools.
Michigan's got like 55 people, support staff.
Did you see what Jim Harbaugh just did? Now he's paying three coaches, including a quarterback coach, over $1 million a year. He just brought on staff a gentleman from the West Coast who has a great resume. He was coaching a high school team. He was coaching with the 49ers when Harbaugh was there. It just so happens, though, that he's the father of the top dual threat quarterback in the class of 2019. So It's all part of the. It's all part. I'm not. This may be the greatest coach in the world, but he's not coming to Michigan unless he's got a son that can play ball.
This thing is spinning out of control quickly, and we're not too far removed from having more coaches than players on the roster. I mean, it's absurd. Not at all schools. All schools have them. Some schools have 2, 3, 4. Yeah. Michigan 55. Alabama 50. LSU's got like 10 or 12 now.
I look at basketball teams and I look at the bench, and there's sometimes there are more guys in suits than in suits, than in basketball suits. It's just amazing. So, it's just like those satellite camps. Until they put a certain restriction to it, it's like the Wild Wild West.
Nobody's breaking the rules, and Saban started this stuff, and I am stunned that the NCAA has not jumped on this yet.
They're still trying to figure out what to do with Ole Miss and North Carolina. They don't have enough manpower or time to come up with these other things. They're trying to put the hammer on these schools. They've been after Ole Miss for 5 years.
Well, one of my old sayings, an acronym, NCAA, no clue at all.
Yeah.
No clue at all on many regards. Some regards, plenty of clue.
Enough manpower. Nobody wants to work in that organization anymore. They're losing people left and right. They're all going now as compliance officers to certain universities.
You know this whole thing, the rich get richer? Take a snapshot of the top 25 of college football in the last couple of years.
It's
not going to change for the next 10 years.
Basketball,
they might move
way.
Around a little bit, you know, and the 8 might be 1 and 16 might become 3 and vice versa. But it is changing the landscape of college football because there's no guidelines to it.
I have always said this for as long as I can remember. I can foresee the day when there is no more NCAA in football. The Power Five conferences join together and they start their own and they get their own commissioner and they get their own television deal and they play within themselves and they come up with their own national championship format. I've said that for the longest time, and I still believe it's going to happen.
The NCAA's got a boatload of money. Why don't they have a football commissioner, a basketball commissioner? You know, I know some of the minor sports you could perhaps combine, okay? But that's way overdue to have a better structure. And I know you don't know the answer to that. I'm just... thinking out loud. I didn't mean to quiz you.
No. I still believe that that's going to happen. I really do. Before
it's
our
overdue.
Time is up. Yeah. Have a commissioner and let him run it.
Coach Ed Orgeron took some time last week to tell you about Tommy Robinson and Mickey Joseph, the two newest full-time. See, we got to go support staff full-time now. We got longer titles again. It's like Rance is involved.
Look, I'm not. I love it when they say it's all about Coach O. Yeah. Coach O has in zeros behind that, you know, in front of that decimal point. Because they're both getting, Mickey Joseph, for sure.
Times
Louisiana Tech
five.
To LSU.
His salary went up
and
times five.
And Robinson from 400 something thousand to 500 up to 600,000. Yeah, it's all about the O.
Here's the head man, the O, Coach Orgeron.
Just a week after the LSU football program parted ways with running backs coach Jabbar Jalouk and wide receivers coach Damian Craig, head coach Ed Orgeron announced the hiring of their replacements.
The first guy I'd like to introduce, he's going to be our assistant head coach. He's going to be our recruiting coordinator. He's going to be our running back coach. Before he gets up here, Tommy Robinson.
Tommy Robinson joins the Tigers from the University of Southern California, where he was running backs coach. Robinson boasts 6 years of NFL experience and over 30 years of coaching.
Every situation is different. It's according to who you have and what the kid shows in practice. If a kid shows that he deserves to play and I feel confident that he can go out there and help this team win, then I'll find a way to play him.
On top of Robinson's resume as a coach, he is one of the nation's best recruiters.
Tommy was recently named a Pac-12 Recruiter of the Year. He is the number 2 ranked recruiter in the country. He's going to be a tremendous asset not only to our running backs, to our recruiting as recruiting coordinator.
Robinson was swayed to come to LSU for one main reason.
It's a lot of good things going on at SC, but The sale was Coach O.
New Orleans native Mickey Joseph joins from Louisiana Tech to coach wide receivers for the Tigers.
We'd like to welcome Mickey Joseph as our wide receiver coach.
With two veteran wide receivers leaving for the NFL draft, Joseph will have his work cut out for him this offseason.
Well, you know what? It's a very talented group. It's a very talented group, so we have a lot of toys to play with.
These guys immediately began working with LSU. Actually, I might have started the day before that presser, and in the meetings, the whole bit. Got to go through the LSU orientation.
That's
learn,
right.
Like, well, so
right.
Learn the ABCs.
Compliance.
Yeah, and then they're gonna have to go to classes and all that
right.
good stuff and
yeah, they,
whatnot.
People don't realize they have to take and
test
to be
and
able
I,
to
I
be a coach.
Say
and it's not
this
easy.
Summer. There's some workshops, for lack of a better word, over in Birmingham at the SEC offices or somewhere in Birmingham where all first-year coaches, head or assistant, in the league in any sport must go over there
okay.
for some compliance stuff.
Makes
and
sense.
And they explain them the flow chart of how the SEC works and all of that. All right, we got interviews with both of these new coaches, and we'll start with Tommy Robinson. He'll be the assistant head coach, the running back coach, and
okay.
recruiting coach. Coordinator.
We have an associate head coach and we have an assistant head coach. So I guess the associate head coach makes more money than the assistant. So
the
I'd rather be an associate
be higher, yeah.
than the assistant.
Yeah.
Okay. Good to know.
Tommy Robinson coming right at you.
Press conference talk about coming from a great program like USC, the LSU, and you really highlighted one reason, Coach Ed Orgeron. Talk about that relationship.
Well, Coach Orgeron and I known each other for a number of years, and I had an opportunity to work with him at USC back in 2013. And he and I just developed a very close relationship. I think we share some of the same ideas and a lot of things that he believed in, I believed in, and it just meshed. And he and I have stayed in close contact ever since then. And not only has he been a good coach and a great guy to work for, Ed Orgeron has been a good friend. He's been a great friend. We got fired in the middle of the season. And I think there was only one guy on the planet at that particular time that could have gotten that team back together and not allow that team to just turn in and say, okay, it's over. Ed Orgeron pulled that team back together and we were fired. And we had the most fun that I've ever had coaching. Every single day I look forward to going to work. I look forward to being around those kids and just being around with Ed and his his enthusiasm, the energy that he bring, the synergy that he created was phenomenal. And that team didn't fall down. That team, actually, we rose up, and we only had a few players. And what Ed Orgeron did to that team and the way he handled the staff, the coaches, our families, the way he dealt with our wives was just outstanding. It was phenomenal. And I say that we were fired because I never had so much fun being fired. I'm from Phenix City, Alabama, born and raised. And like I said, I grew up in SEC country.
It's like the backyard of Auburn almost.
Well, it's about 20 minutes from Auburn.
Yeah.
20, maybe 25 minutes from Auburn University. And everybody in my family that attended the SEC school went to Alabama. And so I've been very familiar with the SEC and being down south, being back in the south is a good thing for me. I really feel like I'm at home. You can hear the southern swing in my voice. So I don't try to hide it. Matter of fact, I embrace it. When I was out in LA, they like, "You're from the south?" Yes, I am. I'm from the south, but I'm an old Troy State Trojan. I went to Troy and. It feels good to be back home near family. My wife is from Selma, Alabama, And, you know, her family's there, and it's just good to be close to family again. Well, you know, someone asked me about that last night, and I said, you know, when I left TCU, we had a kid named LaDainian Thomas.
Yeah.
I leave TCU, and I go to the Dallas Cowboys, and they got a kid over there named Emmitt Smith. And I said, you know, you walk in the room with Emmitt Smith, and who was at that particular time was probably in his ninth year of, you know, full vested vet. And I had to walk in that room and talk to Emmitt. And had some other guys I had to, you know, coach receivers and running backs during the course of the time. Had Michael Irvin, had Deion Sanders. Being around those guys when I was a younger coach has prepared me for the situation that I'm walking into now. I look at an 18, 19, 20-year-old kid right now, and I look forward to the challenge of helping them molding them and helping them become the men that we all want them to be. Because I've had the experience of being a little nervous, and I'll be honest with you, I was nervous when I walked into that room in the Dallas Cowboys.
Yeah.
Now I embrace it, you know, because, you know, I've somewhat laid the foundation for this situation. So now I embrace it, you know, Darius Geis, this Brissette, mm-hmm. And the other guys, I don't want to keep calling names because I know I missed some, but I embrace the opportunity to work with those young men and to be an intricate part of their lives.
Jordy, I've been impressed with Tommy Robinson. I didn't know much of anything at all about him before he was hired. I did not. I had to look it up and read up and all that. One thing I've always felt, and fortunately or unfortunately, in my college baseball career, I had 3 different head coaches and about 10 different assistants. And you don't like it when it happens, but then you kind of look back and you feel like you learned something. But changing a coach tends to kick complacency out of the window in both directions. The players think, hey, we got a new guy here. We really got to be, you know, mm-hmm. cross all the T's, dot all the I's, and get her going here and be impressive. So sometimes, you know, you got to find the silver lining there, and I think they will. But I'm impressed with Tommy Robinson.
I'm impressed when he makes your names, LaDainian Tomlinson and Emmitt Smith and Michael Irvin and primetime
Deion
Sanders. So I'm impressed by that. And that should get the attention of not only the current players, but that should get the attention of recruits. Because let's face it, Geis is gone. Darrell Williams is gone. You have no one proven yet at the running back position. So he's got to go out and get 2, maybe 3 really good running backs, including one workhorse, and that's going to be his goal. That's the task at hand for him. That's what Ed Orgeron told him. Look, I don't care about the on-the-field stuff. That'll be fine. Got to go get me some recruits, plain and simple.
All right, we're going to take a break before we hear from Mickey Joseph. You folks down in New Orleans, he was an outstanding player at Shaw in the West Bank in New Orleans and continued his career at Nebraska. We'll hear from him, but first we have to take a break. Jordy Helper, Tommy Chrisand, you are watching Tigers Roar.
Spread the roar.
Baton Rouge, right? Lafayette, New Orleans, and on the internet at PelicanSportsTV.com. Stay with us.
Acord Eye Clinic Vision Source is located on Perkins Road in Baton Rouge, offering full-service optical and lab work. Dr. Shonda Acord and the professionally trained staff pride themselves on service, complete eye exams, help with contact lenses, and selection of frames featuring Silhouette, Gucci, Jimmy Choo, and all the top lines. State-of-the-art equipment including OptiMap, which digitally photographs your retina. Call Acord Eye Clinic for an appointment, 225-767-3937. That's 225-767-3937. Visit the website, visionsource-br.com. All patients of all ages are welcome. Acord Eye Clinic, Vision Source.
My name is Dr. Nicole Rogers, and I'm here in Old Metairie, Louisiana at Hair Restoration of the South, where your hair is our care. And I'd like to invite you to come and visit and discuss various options for treatment of thinning hair. These can include both medical and surgical options. You don't have to go straight to surgery. In the meantime, feel free to check out our website, hairrestorationofthesouth.com, and we look forward to seeing you soon.
If you've been injured in an accident and you won your case, we can get you your cash fast.
I called Penn Funding and had my money fast.
If you're a victim of an accident, bad drug case, or any other legal settlement, Penn Funding can get you paid in one lump sum.
Instead of my small monthly payments, Penn Funding got me my money when I needed it the most.
Turn your small monthly settlement payments into one large cash payoff right now. If your case is settled, you qualify. And no one can get your money faster than Penn Funding. There's no risk, obligation, or out-of-pocket cost when you make this life-changing call.
I called, answered the questions, and received my cash payoff quickly.
Need cash for your children? To fix your car, pay the bills. If your case is settled and you're a victim of an accident, bad drug case, or any other legal settlement, it's your money. Call Penn Funding now.
Call 800-825-1325, 800-825-1325.
We continue with Tigers Row. We continue to talk about the new additions to the football staff. We heard from Tommy Robinson. We heard Coach Orgeron's comments about both of the guys. And now, you know, that whole recruit New Orleans thing, you know, whatever is going on down there, that's been an age-old story. Does LSU get the right players from New Orleans? Mm-hmm. Certainly don't ever get them all, never will get them all. Many a great one has gotten away and went elsewhere. But now they bring in Mickey Joseph, who had a stellar career at Archbishop Shaw on the West Bank in New Orleans before playing for Tom Osborne with the Nebraska Cornhuskers.
Stop right there. This is the irony of it all. You just mentioned it. He's the top, one of the top players, if not the top player, in the city of New Orleans and the state of Louisiana. He leaves to go to Nebraska. Now his task as a recruiter is to go down to that city and make sure those people don't do what he did. Granted, it was a different era of LSU football back then, but it's ironic that he is going to have to convince people. I would say, well, why did you leave? And he's going to have to tell them why, and he's going to tell them why stay.
Yeah, so, and he'll recruit the greater New Orleans area, which includes the North Shore and the home of Thibodeau area, from Slidell to Hammond and all that stuff. But you're right. But the thing about it is a lot of the high school coaches in New Orleans played against him, right before him, right after him, or maybe some were his teammates, or they hung around a little bit. And he has coached in New Orleans, albeit at Tulane, and a little bit of high school football there. So it's a familiar name in the high school circles in New Orleans.
It's a definite reason why he was hired. And then you just nailed it. You just said it.
Recruit New Orleans.
But he is New Orleans.
Right.
And those coaches know him. And that's what that's certainly a leg up on anyone else. But now the product on the field is what sells. But it certainly doesn't hurt having that coach that, Hey, Joe, good to see you again, man. Remember back in the day? That's all part of the process, no question.
There you go. Well, we want you to hear an interview that was conducted similar to one like the one with Tommy Robinson, but here's running back coach and recruiter in New Orleans, Mickey Joseph.
Oh, yeah, you know, you know, taking it all in the last couple of hours, you know, because when it first happened, you know, you're in between, you know, trying to get my head coach on the phone, get Ed with my head coach, and try to get all the business part out of it. So you really had time to think about it. And, you know, my mom put it in perspective this morning. You know, she said, you know what, you've been out there doing it for 20 plus years, and I've never heard you complain about a job, and I've never heard you run and chase another job. I always hear you say, I'm going to work this job like it's my last job, she said. And it paid off for you. You know, and like I was telling Coach Orgeron, you know, what I'm going to bring to the table with you is that I'm going to be loyal to you. I'm going to be loyal to LSU. I'm going to be loyal to these players. And at the end of the day, I'm going to be an example that they can come behind and say, hey, this is guys that I kind of want to be like. You know, you go back to how you were raised with your parents. You know, and being able to go play at Archbishop Shaw and play under Coach Hank and, you know, be under some good people. And one thing Coach Hank used to always say, that it doesn't take a lot of energy to be a good person. you know. And what I try to do, I try to treat everybody with respect, you know. And if I feel like you're disrespecting me, tell you, and right. still not put you out of my circle, you know, give you a chance, because at the end of the day, I'm not the guy who's going to judge you at the end of your life. And I try to always be a good person, try to always help people, you know, and try to help, you know, just try to help kids in general. You know, the thing about it, I really love, you know, love Louisiana. And we talk about it all the time. And I know my senior year at Nebraska, I remember telling my friends this, like, I'm moving back home. You know, it might not be in the next 2 or 3 years, but when I leave here, I'm going back home, because it just, Louisiana grows on you. And because it's such a great community, you know, everybody's the same here.
Sure.
We all eat the same food. We all raise our kids the same. And the thing about it, it's truly caring in this state. You know, and I know here coming to LSU, some of the most passionate fans that you can ever be a part of. And they don't mean nothing personal about it. They want to win just as much as you. So just coming here to Louisiana and being at Louisiana State right now, it just seems like when we go out and play at other schools outside the state,
sure.
it's Louisiana against that state. And I know I'm on the right side. Coach Orgeron, he used to come to Shaw all the time with Coach Jenkins. They used to always hang out. And when you was on the road recruiting and you was at a school that didn't have a big budget, yeah. and you know you had to eat lunch, you found Coach O. You know,
right.
you found Coach Jenkins. And they take you out to eat and they keep you with them and they show you the work of the land, you
sure.
know, and showed you how to do it and hey just how you need to build this relationship. So we always had a lot of respect, my family, a lot of respect for Coach Orgeron, and had a lot of respect for Coach Jenkins. My family truly, you know, and I tell people this, you know, Coach Jenkins had a chance to recruit me.
Yeah.
You know, and I mean, at the end of the day, he was the one saying, hey, a 5'9 quarterback's not going to play in the NFL. Well, my mama understood it. My dad didn't.
Yeah.
But at the end of the day, my dad knew, hey, boy, we probably should have went to LSU. Because at the end of the day, they missed a lot. You know, they missed
yeah,
a lot.
Sure.
But the relationship with Coach Orgeron is just unbelievable. You know, just unbelievable. And when I got the call, it felt like, you know, we hadn't missed a beat. You know, because I know he's passionate
yes.
about what he can do. And they couldn't hire a better guy. And you couldn't hire a better guy that wants to be here at LSU.
Absolutely.
That wants to, at the end of the day, when you bury him and you bury both of us, we want to be buried in the middle of that field.
Absolutely.
You know, have that crowd, you know, chant LSU. So it's going to be a great opportunity, and it's going to be a great journey.
You said something really hit home with me, technique at the wide receiver mm-hmm. position
Morning.
As we move on the field. And, you know, in this conference, that if you're going to be successful in the pass game, you're going to have to get off the line of scrimmage, and you're going to have to beat man coverage.
Yes. And that's the big thing. When you have kid on this side of the ball, offense, and this side of the ball, defense,
yeah.
and they're both pretty good players, what separates them is that one of them's tougher than the other one, and one of them's going to use technique. And that's one thing I'm preaching, that we're going to be tough as receivers. You know, we're going to be tough. We're going to stick our nose in there. We're going to block.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to stick our nose in there. We're going to block it. I'm going to keep telling them that over and over again, because as far as teaching them how to get off the line of scrimmage, that's not going to be very hard, because they're very athletic. And then my thing is not to overcoach them.
Gotcha.
Let them use their athleticism. Let them do what they normally do. But to also break them down individually. You know, probably don't coach them all the same. Like, this one might need this one. This might need this. You know, just break them down and have, okay, this is what we need to work on with you today. And then at the end of the day, you know, let them know that, hey, I truly care about you as a person before a football person.
Absolutely.
You know, and that's what I'm bringing to the stage with them. And I'm sure they're going to buy in. And like I said, I'm excited.
We continue with Tigers Roar. Jordy, a question for you.
Okay.
His brother recently named head coach of the Denver Broncos, Vance Joseph.
Mm-hmm.
Does that help any when you're recruiting? When you're in there? Yeah, by the way, my brother's head coach of the Denver Broncos.
Might give you a look-see if I give you a recommendation.
I may go
with you to Denver and join up and hook up on the staff with them. So who knows?
Well,
who knows?
You know, you got connections in the league. His brother is a head coach now.
Yeah.
It can't hurt.
Can't hurt.
You know, I don't think it closes a deal.
Here's what players
certainly
want. When a push comes to shove, they want to play early, and they want to play on a winning football team that has a chance to win a national championship. And three, they want to be developed so they can play on Sundays. That's it.
And very few of them will
That's
play
right.
on Sundays.
That's right.
Many more will win the championship.
They will think they can. And when they get up there, then they won't.
Then they'll know.
But LSU has quite a track record.
Everybody's got to hang the cleats up sooner or later.
Oh, yeah.
It's different ages for different people.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, we'll take a break. We'll continue. We'll move forward with more of Tigers Roar here on Pelican Sports TV, Baton Rouge, Lafayette, New Orleans, on the internet at pelicansportstv.com, Cox Cable, AT&T, UVerse, Digital Tuners.
Wow.
Stay with us.
It's a mouthful.
Hello. Hola.
Ni hao.
Experience what the Baton Rouge International School can offer your children. Now welcoming displaced students for short and long-term stability.
If you've been injured in an accident and you won your case, we can get you your cash fast.
I called Penn Funding and had my money fast.
If you're a victim of an accident, bad drug case, or any other legal settlement, Penn Funding can get you paid in one lump sum.
Instead of my small monthly payments, Penn Funding got me my money when I needed it the most.
Turn your small monthly settlement payments into one large cash payoff right now. If your case is settled, you qualify. And no one can get your money faster than Penn Funding. There's no risk, obligation, or out-of-pocket cost when you make this life-changing call.
I called, answered the questions, and received my cash payoff quickly.
Need cash for your children? To fix your car, pay the bills. If your case is settled and you're a victim of an accident, bad drug case, or any other legal settlement, it's your money. Call Penn Funding now.
Call 800-825-1325, 800-825-1325.
My name is Dr. Nicole Rogers, and I'm here in Old Metairie, Louisiana at Hair Restoration of the South, where your hair is our care. And I'd like to invite you to come and visit and discuss various options for treatment of thinning hair. These can include both medical and surgical options. You don't have to go straight to surgery. In the meantime, feel free to check out our website, hairrestorationofthesouth.com, and we look forward to seeing you soon.
DLA Painting Incorporated is your company for professional painting, serving the greater Baton Rouge area and South Louisiana for over 20 years. Ready to paint for those recovering from flood, residential repaint, commercial painting, any size job, free estimates. Customer satisfaction is our highest priority. Call 225-505-8785. DLA Painting Incorporated, fully insured. Call Dennis at DLA Painting at 225-505-8785.
Everyone's coming out with a fresh start. Bars are being banging, elbows are swinging, and the gloves are coming off.
Experience motocross more intense with Amsoil Arena Cross. Before the race, check out the track party and get autographs, take photos, and meet the riders. Stop by any Brothers Food Mart location and pick up a can of Monster Energy 16-ounce at 2 for $4 and recycle at the pit entrance for your free admission to the track party. Brothers Food Mart, often imitated, never duplicated. Amsoil Arena Cross, fueled by Monster Energy, Saturday, March 11th at the Smoothie King Center.
Rejuva-Me Medical, we strive to accomplish a more youthful you. We specialize in the most advanced techniques of testosterone replacement therapy in men, bioidentical hormone replacement in women, IV therapy, and nutritional support, along with the state-of-the-art cosmetics procedures. Experience a network of trainers and health coaches offering diet and nutritional plans tailored to you. Call us today to schedule your free consultation to discuss your individual needs and goals. Look like you live, live younger.
Acord Eye Clinic Vision Source is located on Perkins Road in Baton Rouge, offering full-service optical and lab work. Dr. Shonda Acord and the professionally trained staff pride themselves on service, complete eye exams, help with contact lenses, and selection of frames featuring Silhouette, Gucci, Jimmy Choo, and all the top lines. State-of-the-art equipment including OptiMap, which digitally photographs your retina. Call Acord Eye Clinic for an appointment, 225-767-3937. That's 225-767-3937. Visit the website, visionsource-br.com. All patients of all ages are welcome. Acord Eye Clinic, Vision Source. Cypress Lake Apartments are conveniently located off Segan Lane in Baton Rouge. Come see this community, which has many amenities including swimming pools, fitness room, playground, and much more. Beautiful views of Cypress Lake. 1, 2, 3-bedroom apartments are available. Stop by and see Cypress Lake Apartments. Give them a call at 225-293-6789 or visit online cypresslake-apartments.net.
Continue with Tigers Roar. I want to remind you about the radio station that's part of Pelican Broadcasting over here, WUBR, an affiliate of CBS Sports Radio. Yeah, you can get the app at TuneIn. Home of the Jim Rome Show, Monday through Friday from 11 to 1. The daily local radio lineup with Jordy Hultberg, Buddy Sanji, myself, Dave Scandaliato on Fridays. The weekend's fine, Carlos Brown. Louisiana Music Hall of Fame radio through the night. We'll have select Houston Astros Major League Baseball this spring. CBS Sports Radio, great mixture of local and national stuff. The smartphones, the internet, the tablets, the mobile devices. All you do is search for WUBR and you got it.
You mentioned Houston Astros. Alex Bregman penciled in, starting third baseman. Ready to roll.
He is also on the USA team for the World Baseball Congress, as is Jonathan Lucroy, who played at ULL. So, a little Louisiana flavor on that.
Bregman was there before. He beat the pitchers and catchers to their setup.
Doesn't surprise.
And he was there. He's just a baseball rat.
While on the subject of radio, in the Lafayette market, you have the program in the afternoon. Give it a shout out.
KLWB 103.7 FM, The Game. Every afternoon from 2 to 4, we bring the Tigers to all the Tigers in Acadiana.
There you go. All right, good stuff, 2 to 4, and, of course, 7 to 9 here in the mornings, and I'm 3 to 5 in the afternoons.
Here we go. Just a long day. This is a long day.
Yeah, Wednesday's is a long day for both you and I. It starts really early. It ends
two radio, late. Two TV, and...
Media mogul, that's what he is.
Man, just glad to
Jordy,
be here.
Jordy, it took, let's see, let me do
spring
some.
Spring football. Spring football game is on a Saturday night. Remember the last time?
You were correct. It was
remember
DiNardo.
The last time? DiNardo, his first year?
You said that a couple weeks ago.
Tried to set a record. I think they got 40,000 people there.
All right, I'm doing some math here.
Uh-oh. You're a good mathematician.
It took right under an hour for us to get
No, you this. Started off at the top of the show.
Oh, yeah, I took a swipe. With LSU basketball.
You just chopped them down.
Okay. Well, okay, for those of you who may have missed the beginning, we showed Shaquille O'Neal hitting the three-pointer on the anniversary of the SEC title team from 1991. And as it when it ended, I said, there's the LSU basketball season highlight tape.
They lost again, 12 straight.
Lose to Ole Miss after leading by three at half.
If
having
they had
a lead in the second half, they dropped their 12th straight, Jordy.
If they had played a high school game, which is in my higher mathematics, 4 quarters, 8-minute quarters, 32 minutes, they would have won. But the last 8 minutes of the game, they got outscored tremendously and they end up losing by 20. There's a stat out there. In the last 12 minutes of the game, Antonio Blakeney, who was your leading scorer, ended up with 29. In the last 12 minutes, he had 3 touches and took no shots. How's that possible? How is that possible?
I blame that on both Blakeney and the coaching staff.
I do.
Blakeney's got to be saying, give me the ball. He's got to look at his teammates on the floor. Ball goes out of bounds. Bam, get me the dang ball. I'm going to shoot it. And then Johnny Jones needs to be calling out time. I think, give number two to basketball.
I'm afraid to say this. Auburn may be their last possible chance for a win.
And that's in Baton Rouge next Tuesday.
Slight, yes.
They only lost to Auburn by 4 over there.
Yeah, that's their...
I think this. I'm going to make this statement. Then I got a question for you about...
You have lots of questions.
That's what we're doing here, isn't it?
Yeah, okay. I'll try to answer them.
I hope this team wins a game somewhere.
Oh, gosh.
Listen, one or two wins is certainly not going to put them in the postseason, and I don't think it'll change the status of Johnny Jones. But for the kids, I'd like them to be able to taste a victory again. I don't care who. I don't care about 1 point or 12 points. I would like to see them somewhere, somehow find a W.
I'm with you. Auburn might be the answer. We'll see.
Yeah. Now, I got a question for you. This is not about LSU.
Okay.
You know, why is it still two halves? Why can't we have four quarters? I mean, the women went to four quarters. I know you got media timeouts, after 16, 12, 8, and 4.
I don't have the answer to that. You know what I like about the girls' game? Late in the game, like under a minute to go, if you call a timeout, you can advance the ball to the front court like the NBA does. I think it's great. Late game situations.
Well, they want you to,
Yeah, I wish the men would do that as well. I think eventually it will turn to that, but men's college
that's
basketball.
That's kind of its identity.
Wants its own identity.
Got two. Okay, that's just something I thought about when you mentioned earlier about the first half and the second half. But LSU loses it to Ole Miss. They are on the road Saturday, 2:30 tip against Alabama. We'll have the post game show at about 4:30 Saturday afternoon. They're home next Tuesday night against Auburn.
Is that another 8 o'clock night?
Six.
Six? Oh, good.
And then they got a road game at Georgia, and then they're home against Tennessee. There's only two remaining home games. Auburn on next Tuesday the 21st, and on Wednesday the 1st, it'll be Tennessee coming to town, and that'll be the...
It's a shame. It really is. I don't know how you go from being double digits up in the second half, ended up losing by 20 to a team...
That's
marginal at best.
In the league coming in.
Marginal at best. I don't know how that happens.
Well,
I just don't know.
There's no magic wand, and you're not going to change this. But, again, I hope somehow, somewhere, they get a win somewhere just so they can say, hey, we snapped the streak. We got us a W. Just somehow, some way, go ahead and get that worked out. But, man. And then, of course, women's basketball. They had a difficult loss the other day.
Vanderbilt.
In Nashville.
They only had one win in the league.
I mean, it's just not a good thing. You know, Coach Nikki Farkas, she's in her sixth year, and this was a game they should not have lost in Nashville. As you said, Vanderbilt has struggled significantly, and it's just not. They're doing a little better than the guys, but it's not much better.
No, that was a golden opportunity. They're knocking on the NCAA tournament door. They really are in a very good league that has a great reputation, unlike the men's league in the SEC. The women's league is very highly regarded, and you can't go and lose a game like that on the road. You just can't against a team in Vanderbilt that only has one win in conference play all season long. So a very difficult loss for Nikki Farkas' club. They play Thursday night. At home, so hopefully they can bounce back. They've got to accumulate wins. You don't want to leave it all up in their hands come SEC tournament time. Speaking of women's basketball, UConn, 100 straight wins. I don't care what the competition is. I don't care whether you like women's college basketball, despise it. 100 in a row is 100 in a row. They had to have a bad shooting night in that streak. They had to have a night when they weren't all on, feeling great about themselves and they were lethargic, and yet they still find a way to win. That is mind-boggling.
You know, 100 in a row, that's
mind-boggling.
I don't care if it's youth basketball. That's incredible. You know, I think back, you and I were younger when UCLA won 88 in a row, and nobody's ever come close to that since. And now here's 100. And again, I know what you're saying. It's women's basketball, and 50% of the teams they play would lose 100 in a row to them. I get that. Okay, it's a power. It's dominant. But
and this is supposed to be the year that they were down because they lost
way down.
The
yeah.
first, second, and third overall pick in the WNBA draft came off their team. And they're supposed to be down, and they're better than ever before.
And again, Nikki Farkas in her sixth year at LSU. We'll take a look at the upcoming games. Again, that tough loss up in Nashville by the Lady Tigers. And they got to try to make a little run here, maybe make some noise in the SEC tournament. And we'll see if, again, they're doing a little better than the men, but we'll see if Nikki Farkas can get this ladies' team to the postseason.
Yeah.
I think if she gets to the postseason, her job is secure. When before the season, there were questions whether there'd be a change in men's and women's basketball.
Let's think about this year. LSU football has been a disappointment. No question about that. LSU men's basketball, major disappointment. Women's basketball, you know, it's up to LSU baseball and LSU softball to save the day. And both of those teams, highly, highly ranked softball team, and we'll talk about that later, but they got off to a great start. They're 4-1, and of course, we await the opener of LSU baseball this Friday.
Yeah, and we'll get into some baseball a little bit later when we visit with Ronnie Rance. Obviously, he's got a pulse on that injury bug jumping up on Paul Maneri. LSU softball, the Lady Tigers, Coach Beth Tarina, they got off to a good start opening weekend in the Tiger Classic out at Tiger Park. As they win that Classic, they go 4-1 against the likes of Oklahoma State, Penn State, and McNeese State. They got a tournament coming up, the Purple and Gold Challenge, this weekend, again out at Tiger Park. Georgia Southern and Central Arkansas, a couple of doubleheaders there. Obviously not conference play yet, but Beth Tarina's softball team off to a good start.
Yeah, their one loss was to Penn State, as you mentioned, and they came back in a fervor and demolished them like 14-1 the second time.
Which in softball is like 80-0 in football.
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely. So she's got good pitching and expect really good things. And I told her this, it's a compliment to you, Beth Tarina, that when you mention LSU softball, just like LSU baseball says Omaha or bust, women's softball says Oklahoma City or bust. So that's quite a compliment to have your program at that level.
Speaking of softball, we got a little piece on it for you with Coach Tarina and a recap of the opening weekend. And as we run through the LSU Athletic Department here, we want to share that with you. Enjoy this little piece on the Lady Tiger softball program.
The Lady Tigers were looking for revenge after losing to Penn State on Friday. And if revenge is a dish best served cold, then the ladies should pull it out of the freezer, because that's just what they got. They ran it up on the Lions, defeating them 14-1.
This time we just came in kind of with, I don't know how you'd say it, some blood in our veins, and we wanted to come back and, you know, really put on a good performance.
Pitcher Allie Walljasper was dominant on the mound, allowing only one run on three hits. But it wasn't as nice for the Nittany Lions. Three Penn State pitchers gave up 8 runs in the third inning alone.
And they did a great job. Everybody that we asked to come out and play today stepped up. And, you know, hopefully that was a good answer back from what happened yesterday.
Senior Bailey Landry looked impressive too, going 3-for-4 and hitting in a run.
I felt pretty good about it. Definitely improved in the second game. I was seeing the ball. I think just in the first game, I was hitting it kind of right at people. So I made some adjustments and got it the second game.
The Lady Tigers are going to be back on the field Sunday when they take on Oklahoma State.
I think our team wanted to send a message about yesterday. I think, you know, they wanted to come out and make sure they did their jobs. And they did a great job. Everybody that we asked to come out and play today stepped up. And, you know, hopefully that was a good answer back for what happened yesterday.
And McNeese State, they're never an easy game. They weren't in the postseason last year and not today.
Their third baseman and I actually talked about that somewhere in the middle of the game. Of why can't this ever just be easy? But they're a great team, and that's why. They're a great team. They're a great program. They're an in-state rival. So I think anytime you have teams like that, it's always going to be tough. And we respect them a lot, and we were lucky to come away with one today from them.
The two different responses from your team, first game, close win, second game, big time win. You're learning a lot about your team early on in the season, aren't you?
I think we grew up a lot today, honestly, and I think I'm getting better at how to manage our personnel. I think I have a long road ahead still to understand how to manage this group and how to utilize our strengths, and, you know, I think we all got better today, though.
You guys coming in ranked 4th in the nation, you know, did you expect the early slip-up with Penn State, and how do you think your team has responded from it?
You know, I don't think you ever expect to come out and lose. I expected us to take some lumps with a young team. You know, I don't think you ever expect that from them. You expect to win every game, right? So, you know, I expected our pitching to be a little bit better. But, again, I think we're all learning some things. I think we will just continue to grow. And, you know, hopefully what we did tonight is enough to send a message that, you know, we are capable of making
Do you think it's a positive being able to face adversity somewhat early in the season? Do you think that's going to help these players grow more?
I would much rather do it the easy way. I mean, I would much rather do it without the loss. I think there's ways you can face adversity without having to lose games. But, you know, we lost the game, so we'll try to make the most of it, and we'll try to learn from it, and we'll try to use it in that way. But I would much rather not lose the game if, you know, that's an option.
Beth, Bailey Landry says that she just wants to take advantage of the opportunities wherever she gets them. 3-for-4 tonight in the game against Penn State. What do you think of her?
I mean, she's a special player. I think we've come to expect that from Bailey Landry. You know, she just has so many weapons, so many tools, and I just think she's capable about anything. I think she did a great job tonight, and, you know, we've all come to expect that from her.
Yeah.
So.
That's great. Anybody else? Appreciate it. I'm sorry.
You moved Sanchez from second to third. How do you think she's moving herself in third so far?
I was so impressed with her, honestly. I think Shamaya has done such a great job. So athletic over there. I mean, a couple of plays she made tonight are not easy, what she did. So not to mention just her approach at the plate, and not even the fact that she's getting hit. She's having really intelligent conversations. She's bought into everything we've asked her to do. I'm really excited about what we're seeing from her. I'm excited from a lot of the corners, and I'm excited about Sydney Springfield and what she was able to do today. What a great day from a freshman. I think that was a really special performance. And, you know, so many questions about our four-hole and where it's going to be. And I think a lot of those, Wall, Jasper, Springfield, Doyle, Shamaya, those guys are really stepping up and making a case for that spot.
As I mentioned, we'll get into some of the baseball stuff a little later.
I like the response. I'd much rather win and learn from that than lose and have to learn my lesson from losing. So she's good at what she does.
She's done very, very well with that program. It was kind of odd circumstances when she got the job. They'd hired somebody. He was here for like 24 hours and then change of mind.
Best hire of Joe Oliva's tenure at this point in time.
Yep.
Proven, yes.
Yeah, I'll go with that. To date, we'll see. Bergeron wins the national championship.
That'll be considered
pretty good.
Absolutely.
All right, we're going to take a break. When we come back, Brian Lazar, TigerBait.com. We'll talk about Arden Key leaving the team, Brandon Harris leaving the team, and a bunch of other things with Brian when we return after this pause on Pelican Sports TV. Stay with us.
It's a mailbag.
Since 1986, the family dental practice of Dr. Farrell Frugier, with state-of-the-art building and technology and our highly trained staff, have been dedicated to providing care and treatment to our patients of all ages. The experience and advanced training in cosmetic and restorative dentistry, TMJ, and treatment of snoring and sleep apnea allows Dr. Frugier to assist you in achieving the best in dental health. Call us today at 225-292-9700 to schedule your initial evaluation, because we know how to make you smile.
Hello, my name is Debbie. Welcome to Debbie's Bridal, a formal affair.
Raven, I work at Debbie's Bridal, and she makes your dreams come true.
Acord Eye Clinic Vision Source is located on Perkins Road in Baton Rouge, offering full-service optical and lab work. Dr. Shonda Acord and the professionally trained staff pride themselves on service, complete eye exams, help with contact lenses, and selection of frames featuring Silhouette, Gucci, Jimmy Choo, and all the top lines. State-of-the-art equipment, including OptiMap, which digitally photographs your retina. Call Acord Eye Clinic for an appointment, 225-767-3937. That's 225-767-3937. Visit the website, visionsource-br.com. All patients of all ages are welcome. Acord Eye Clinic, Vision Source.
We continue with Tigers Roar. With Jordy Holtberg, I'm Tommy Kreisand. We're now joined by Brian Lazar of TigerBait.com. Good evening, Brian. How are you?
Good. How y'all doing tonight?
Not good, Brian. Not good. My basketball team, how do you go from up double digits to losing by 20 at the end in less than 20 minutes? I don't see how that happens.
Less than 20? Did it in less than 12.
Less than 12, yes. I'm trying to be generous.
Look, I pointed this out to a basketball, LSU basketball fan today who follows it pretty closely, and he didn't even realize this. Last year on February the 6th, LSU defeated Mississippi State in the PMAC, and that win gave LSU an 8-2 record in the conference.
Ooh.
Since that game, LSU has played 8 more conference games last year, two games in the SEC tournament last year, and they have played 13 SEC games this year.
That's 23 games.
Since that, they were 8-2 in the last 23 games.
This is going to be scary.
5 wins, 18 losses.
Ooh.
And 13 of the 18 losses by double digits.
Ooh.
Would you say that the program has totally collapsed?
Yes.
It has bottomed out. There's
yes.
no question.
No question.
Especially when you take that
wow.
snapshot.
I did not know that stat.
That you just described, Brian. And, you know, I don't know what we can say that hadn't been said in the last month plus or during this 12-game losing streak, but it's an ugly mess. And my opinion, you know, 99.9% sure there'll be a change in the coaching office when the season concludes after the SEC tourney.
Well, look, the school record for consecutive losses is 14. I think the LSU will be hard-pressed to win at Alabama on Saturday. So
Auburn's their last chance.
So that would be 13. And so that means when Auburn comes here next Tuesday night, you know, if LSU loses that game, that would match the longest losing streak in school history.
Wow. There okay. we go. Well, we'll see.
Let's change the card.
Yeah, we're speaking. Well, no, I got to tell Brian what I did at the beginning of the show. Should I do that?
Sure.
Brian, our little opening clip on the show showed Shaquille O'Neal hitting that three-pointer before the game last Saturday when they had the anniversary of the SEC 91 team.
And right.
I opened the show right after we showed that, and I said, there is your basketball season highlight tape.
That's terrible. Isn't that terrible?
Jody said I was unfair. That was a swipe.
No, that wasn't a swipe. That was just a full-fledged blade to the neck.
The problem is it might be true.
Yeah, you're right. Let's change to football.
Ryan, first, your reaction to the Brandon Harris announcement that he's leaving the program. Two-part question. One, the announcement that he's leaving. Two, the timing of it.
Well, look, I thought all along that Brandon Harris was going to leave. I thought he would wait. Remember, he was an early enrollee, so he could probably graduate. So I figured he would graduate. Once he graduates, he would be able to transfer where he wouldn't lose a year of eligibility at a FBS school. So I think what people were surprised at, well, why didn't he go and he's got a new offensive coordinator and let him compete at spring practice, and maybe he's going to beat Danny Etling. Now, look, I don't know. I'm sure he's had some conversations with Matt Canada in the last week or so, and I'm sure Matt Canada said, you know, there'll be a competition. We'll leave it, go from there. Certainly, he's behind Etling, and I make this point. Yes, Matt Canada is the new offensive coordinator. And he'll determine who the quarterback will be. But just think, after Ed Orgeron took over last year, there were plenty of opportunities for Brandon Harris to get into games, and he never played a snap. I think there was one or two games, that was it. And that just tells me that, you know, and everything Ed Orgeron had said last year was that Danny Etling is now our quarterback, and I just think that they're going to go with him. And you know, certainly Brandon Harris wants to go somewhere so we can play as a senior. He's got 1 year left. So,
well,
there's no need for him to go through spring practice. In his mind, you know, he's not going to beat out Danny Etling, and I think that he probably believes he's not going to beat Etling out.
Etling's one hit away from being out, and the question now is you've got 4 quarterbacks. Only one has thrown a pass in a legitimate college football game, and all the others haven't. So the big question is now, once again, it's going to be a big storyline. Who's the backup quarterback going to be?
Well, Brian, here's a silver lining, if you will, and it's an analogy to our next topic, Arden Key. If Brandon Harris is not at spring practice, that means the other guys will get the reps that he would have got, and maybe one of them gets better or something gets noticed by the coaching staff that they wouldn't have noticed had whoever that next guy is not gotten as many reps. But, you know, that's just an observation trying to find a silver lining. Brian, a press release came out today about Arden and Key taking a leave from the program. You read the release. Everyone has read it. Just your thoughts when you became aware of that.
Well, I know I've talked with a lot of people this afternoon, and I have not talked to one person who says this is the reason, this is what his personal issue is. So I don't believe, you know, certainly he knows, and Ed Orgeron knows, and people at LSU know, but I don't think that it's known for anybody publicly to say this is the reason. I guess I'm sort of confused, or not confused, you know, the fact that LSU made an announcement like this, which, I mean, they didn't have to make an announcement, and he could be away from the team right now during conditioning drills and winter workouts, and if he was going to be back with the team at the start of spring practice, then okay, he's out there, and nobody would know that he had missed some, you know, drills. So the fact that LSU made a statement like that makes me think that there's no guarantee that he will be back for the start of spring practice. And again, I don't know what the personal issue. I mean, I've seen where his father's made a statement that he's healthy and he's fine. So I don't know, like I said, but the fact that LSU made a statement like that just tells me, well, maybe, you know, when they start spring practice, he's not going to be out there. And if he's not, well, LSU's already covered.
Yeah, they don't have to answer questions.
They don't have to deal with it then because they said, well, he's dealing with this personal issue.
Yeah, they won't have to talk about it on March 11th. Brian, baseball season gets underway this weekend. Air Force, Army, military recognition, military appreciation. Should be a special weekend at the box. Always a special for the season opener and the opening weekend. And I know lots of folks are looking forward to baseball this year. Paul Menary's 11th year, but a team that's been bitten by the injury bug a good bit before the first pitch is thrown.
Yeah, you know, if everybody thought that LSU is going to go, they play 18 games before they open up the conference against Georgia, and say, well, LSU's going to just roll through these 18 games, and they have a bump or two. They got to play TCU. They got a three-game series with Maryland, who's ranked. So maybe a bump or two, and that'll be it. Well, I think what has happened here, like you said, with the injuries, makes this far more interesting what's going to happen in this next month. You know, no Bryce Jordan for the year, the designated hitter. What Paul has said, it's not replacing Bryce Jordan as designated hitter. It's replacing Bryce Jordan as a middle-of-the-lineup hitter. I think LSU's got plenty of guys that can go in there and be the DH, but I don't know if they have guys who are mentally ready to handle batting in the middle of the lineup. And, Tommy, you know, you being a former pitcher, you know what I'm talking about.
Right.
There's a difference batting eighth and ninth than there is batting fourth and fifth.
Big difference.
And I think that's the concern. Now you got Greg Dykeman. You know, he gets hit in the face by a pitch. I mean, it sounds like that Bryce Adams is going to DH this weekend. So if Adams is going to DH, that, you know, you certainly, I don't expect Dykeman to be out playing right field. So that hints that he's going to at least miss this weekend. And again, you know, guys play after getting hit in the face by a pitch. You know, they'll go to the plate and wear a batting helmet. And, you know, once they get through the initial fear, you know, they're fine. But, you know, it wouldn't surprise me to see Dykeman miss a couple weeks. And then you have Jordan Romero. You say, well, that's a possible guy who could step in and be a DH. And, you know, he's had nothing but injury problems beginning in the fall. He had couldn't throw, so he wasn't able to catch. He's fallen behind Nick Coombs as the number two catcher, and then he turned an ankle last week. And, you know, Paul had said he thought he would miss just last week of practice, and now it seems like that he's going to probably be out again this week. So when you look at it, you know, this experienced returning everyday lineup, when LSU goes against Air Force on Friday. Now you're down only five guys in the lineup back from last year. You got Michael Papirski at catcher. You have Cole Freeman and Kramer Robertson in the infield. And you have Bo Jordan and Antoine Duplantis in the outfield. So you're down to those five guys. And so it's a little bit different look. Paul's going to have to tinker with the batting order a little bit and try to determine who needs to be in there. And of course, they still have some questions to answer with the pitching, you know, who's the third starter and who's going to be the setup guys in the bullpen. But, you know, here's the one good thing about this team. You talk about juniors and seniors. Well, LSU's got Robertson, Freeman, Papirski, Bo Jordan, Dykeman. That's five returning position players who are juniors or seniors. Your top two starting pitchers are a junior and a senior, and your closer is a senior. So when you have that many juniors and seniors back with returning experience, you should have a pretty good team, and that's why LSU should have a pretty good team this year. It's a matter of those eight guys, you know, what the freshman pitcher who's the number three starter, that's not going to be as important as what these older guys do. You know, you're as good as your older players, and if your older players play well, you got a chance to have a championship team.
All right, Brian, we look forward to the weekend at the box. Brian, before you get out of here, tell everybody what's happening at TigerBait.com.
www.tigerbait.com. Coverage of the opening of the baseball season as we go to the end of the basketball season, and obviously it looks like a coaching search will be in play in a few weeks. And then, keeping up with football, there'll be some spring recruiting taking place in the next couple of weeks, and Mike Scarborough will have all the latest on that on the site.
All right, Brian, as always, we appreciate it, and we'll talk to you again soon.
Okay, talk to you guys later.
All right, appreciate it. Brian Lazar, TigerBait.com, with his usual solid contribution. We're going to take a break. When we come back, we're going to talk the Barrister Bowl. You know what that is? It's the 13th annual LSU Law School Barrister Bowl. We've promoted it before here on the station, and we're going to do it again right after this pause on Pelican Sports TV, Baton Rouge, Lafayette, New Orleans, on the internet at PelicanSportsTV.com. Stay with us.
Everyone's coming out with a fresh start. Bars are going to be banging, elbows are swinging, and the gloves are coming off.
Experience motocross, more intense, with Amsoil Arena Cross. Before the race, check out the track party and get autographs, take photos, and meet the riders. Stop by any Brothers Food Mart location and pick up a can of Monster Energy 16-ounce at 2 for $4 and recycle at the pit entrance for your free admission to the track party. Brothers Food Mart, often imitated, never duplicated. Amsoil Arena Cross, fueled by Monster Energy, Saturday, March 11th at the Smoothie King Center.
I knew I could get myself out of this. I just needed some hope and some help.
I took the first step to recovery when I made the call.
If you're depressed, drinking, and using drugs, you may need help. And the Affordable Care Act guarantees coverage of substance abuse. Call the Addiction, Hope, and Helpline now for a free assessment.
I had problems just getting to sleep, drinking, and using pills every night.
I feel like I'm losing control. I'm afraid I'll lose my job or even my family.
Are you losing hope? You can recover and get back on track. Call now for hope and help with proven gentle recovery programs.
I never thought that I could be somebody who didn't drink and use drugs.
I have something to hold on to for strength. I'm in recovery, getting the help I need.
Call the Addiction, Hope, and Helpline now for a free assessment with someone who cares.
Call 800-383-8177. 800-383-8177.
DLA Painting Incorporated is your company for professional painting, serving the greater Baton Rouge area and South Louisiana for over 20 years. Ready to paint for those recovering from flood, residential repaint, commercial painting, any size job, free estimates. Customer satisfaction is a highest priority. Call 225-505-8785. DLA Painting Incorporated, fully insured. Call Dennis at DLA Painting at 225-505-8785.
Nothing could ever bring me down.
My name is Dr. Nicole Rogers, and I'm here in Old Metairie, Louisiana at Hair Restoration of the South, where your hair is our care. And I'd like to invite you to come and visit and discuss various options for treatment of thinning hair. These can include both medical and surgical options. You don't have to go straight to surgery. In the meantime, feel free to check out our website, hairrestorationofthesouth.com, and we look forward to seeing you soon.
Cypress Lake Apartments are conveniently located off Segan Lane in Baton Rouge. Come see this community, which has many amenities including swimming pools, fitness room, playground, and much more. Beautiful views of Cypress Lake. 1, 2, 3-bedroom apartments are available. Stop by and see Cypress Lake Apartments. Give them a call at 225-293-6789 or visit online cypresslake-apartments.net.
Continue with Tigers Roar. The set is looking a lot better right now, and it's not because of me. It's because of our guests that we have, in particular our cheerleader here. But it's the LSU Law School Barrister Bowl. I'm joined by Chris Ordy. Chris, good evening. How are you?
Good, good. Thanks for having us, Tom. We really appreciate it.
Hey, we've been able to help promote you guys in past years. Right. It's the annual LSU Law School Barrister Bowl, the 13th annual. Chris, tell us a little bit about the history of this. How did this all come to be? I mean, you guys are going to be playing tackle football. We got the cheerleaders. I mean, tell me how this thing has grown.
So I love it when people ask me this, flag football game? No, full contact. We have pads donated by local high schools this year. Scotlandville High School, McKinley High School, and St. Thomas More High School donated. It started 13 years ago by Jason Durden. Graduate, and it was just intended for some camaraderie to start between players, you know, students and whatnot, for a good cause to raise.
How do they go about splitting the teams?
So we go about splitting the teams, just a pure, simple draft. You know, a couple guys get
that's
together.
An interesting evening, huh?
Yeah, there might be a little backdoor deals going on, but a couple guys get together. They recruit the 1L class, and they all pick. You know, there's really not much to it. There's not much to it.
So how many guys are on each team?
Typically, we usually have about 30 guys on each team.
And this is full. I mean, we got some footage we'll show, but this is football. Like you said, it's not flag football. It's not two-hand touch. It's not be all nice and friendly and fun, as we can see highlights from a previous game. I mean, you got the unis going, and they're hitting out there.
It's comparable to a high school JV team.
High school? Game. Yo, yeah. You took a shot right there. Are you playing in this game?
I am. I will be playing in this game.
And you know people are going to hear you take that shot
sure.
from the other team.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
What position are you playing?
I'll be a wide receiver, defensive end.
Don't. Just keep your head on a swivel after that comment, okay?
Yeah. I don't know if I'll be catching anything over the middle.
Yeah, you can just go veer out to the sideline. But again, the game, obviously, some rain in that game there. Having a little fun. And I want you to tell us who we also have here on the set that has improved the looks.
So joining me here is Mr. J.P. Graff from Crawley, Notre Dame High School graduate.
Did you play football for Louis Cook?
I did.
All right. Yeah. So you didn't think I knew that, huh? Go ahead.
And Ms. Megan Trahan from HOMA.
HOMA. E.D. White.
Vanderbilt Catholic.
I was close. But anyway, so all right, the cheerleaders. I mean, you got cheerleaders for both teams. I mean, this is a full-blown deal.
It is. But we only have one cheerleading squad, just one gigantic.
Cheers for the game.
How many cheerleaders we have this year, do you know?
We have 52.
52 cheerleaders.
That's just about as many football players also.
All right, now, there's a charity that benefits from the proceeds, and that's admirable that the group has done this through the years. Tell us about this year's charity and about the event this year.
So this year's charity is, we're doing a repeat. Last year we donated to American Cancer Society in the name of Professor Chaney Joseph, who passed away last year. We decided again to go with American Cancer Society because it was so successful, and we formed a relationship with them. Also, we felt that since we were the last class that Chaney Joseph taught, that it would be a great thing to continue. And so that's who we decided. I think we raised close to $10,000 last year.
Yeah, and we got the information on the screen. That's the cover of y'all's magazine at the game, the Barristers Bowl, number 13. It'll be Saturday, February the 18th at Brex Memorial Stadium, a 12:30 kickoff, again, benefiting the American Cancer Society. We got an email address and a website down there if you want to get more information, maybe make a donation that'll help go to the Cancer Society, or better yet, if you need one of those football fixes, they can get out to Memorial Stadium this Saturday.
Absolutely.
And you got the referees, I mean, everything, right?
Volunteer referees, they come out every year.
Because of benefits, cancer, yeah.
We do kind of tailor the rules. We have one kickoff, that's it, no punts. Couple years ago, they didn't allow the defense to return interceptions, but we worked them this year. They're going to let us do that this year.
All right, now, okay, we don't want anybody to get hurt.
Right.
I'm thinking there's an injury every year. I
mean,
you guys aren't, you know, you're in shape when you played at Notre Dame. I mean, you're not used to what goes on in a real football game.
No, by no means are we in real top-of-the-line playing shape. But we will have an athletic trainer on site. Acadian Ambulance always
has a couple volunteers.
And usually we have an orthopedic surgeon or a doctor as well.
All right, now, are there any, like, side wagers that you guys get going on? Because you say it's a draft, so you could have a good friend on the other team.
Yeah.
You know, you might have somebody you're not wild and crazy
Apparently,
about.
Apparently, we have a buddy who's supposed to drop the line tomorrow.
We got a betting line. Holy smokes. I tell you what we're going to do. You need to come on the radio with me this Friday.
All right.
I'll touch base with you tomorrow. And we're going to get, I want to know the betting line, and then that'll give it further promotion.
Oh,
and you can do it via the phone. You don't have to roll into the studio. But I'll get a hold of you tomorrow.
Perfect.
But again, y'all are looking forward to having a fun time.
Oh, yeah. It always is a great time. It's really, it's become a really good point between alumni and students, you know, something to connect with them. I also feel like it's been a really big selling point for the school when students are coming and visiting the school, you know, and say, look, you know, we do this big charity event. No other law school in the country does this. It really sets us apart.
Well, you guys will be to be commended for a couple of things. One, you're helping a charity. You're having fun while you're doing it. You're creating a bond among law school students, those who have graduated and are already out there paying back their loans.
Right.
Can I say that?
Yeah.
and those who are, you know, successful, and this is a growing thing. And since it's been going 13 years, I've got reason to believe it's going to go for a long time.
Continue.
And you guys are going to come back as old timers one day. You realize that, huh?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Okay. See, because I played college baseball, so I've been to the old timers game. So not at LSU, at Southeastern. But anyway, hey, let's get the graphic back up there again. And Chris, I want you to again tell everybody. Let's give them the details to who, what, where, when for this Saturday afternoon for the 13th annual Barrister Bowl.
Barrister's Bowl, LSU Law School annual charity event will be this Saturday, February 18th. Kickoff is scheduled for 12:30, and it will be benefiting the American Cancer Society.
And you got an email address down there, website address, the Barrister Bowl logo, purple and gold, obviously the colors
purple
and everything.
Gold.
We got a jersey here with a little black numbers on it. But look, if you didn't have time to write all that down, get a hold of us here at Pelican Sports TV or Pelican Radio, and we'll get you the necessary information, and we'll get Chris to jump in on the radio with us Friday for a little further publicity.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Well, I appreciate y'all coming out here tonight, taking your time.
Thank you, Tommy.
And, yeah, we've done this before, and I know you guys are going
to
pass this along, but always give us a holler, and we'll be happy to promote what you guys are doing. It's our little way of helping you guys be successful.
Thank you. We really appreciate
it. All right. Appreciate that. We're going to take a break. Come back. More of Jordy Hultberg still to come. Ronnie Rance, Sports Shorts Radio, Sports Shorts TV, and the Louisiana Sports Hall of Fame Foundation. Are we going to have a cheer on the way out of here or no? There we go. We're back with more Tigers Roar. Stay with us.
Plus Benefits has an important message for all uninsured Americans. It's official. Health reform has now become law. Now, uninsured Americans can finally get the health coverage they need with significant prescription benefits. Have you been uninsured, denied coverage, or struggling to pay your health insurance? Well, not anymore. Now there's affordable options with real benefits for people just like you. We know health insurance costs and being denied coverage due to pre-existing conditions has created serious hardships for many Americans. But that's a thing of the past. If you're uninsured, struggling to afford, or have been denied health insurance, pick up the phone and call now. The call is free, and every caller will receive a free discount prescription savings card. Call Plus Benefits Health Insurance Helpline today and get the health insurance and prescription coverage you need. One call can change your life for the better.
Please call 800-351-1511. That is 800-351-1511.
Hello, my name is Debbie. Welcome to Debbie's Bridal, a formal affair.
I work at Debbie's Bridal, and she makes your dreams come true.
We continue with Tigers Roar. Jordy Hultberg, Tommy Chrisand with you as we roll on. Original airing each week's on a Wednesday. If you're catching this Thursday, Friday, or Saturday, you have a rebroadcast going, or maybe you're watching on YouTube. .com/Pelican Broadcasting. Right now, we're joined by Ronnie Rantz, Sports Shorts Radio, Sports Shorts TV, Louisiana Sports Hall of Fame Foundation. Ronnie, good evening. How are you?
Doing great, fellas.
Hey, Ronnie, LSU baseball, 11th season under Paul Menneri, the lid lifter, the season opener Friday night. It's the season opening weekend. Ronnie, you're a two-time World Series champion. Tell us what's going to be going on in the minds and in the stomachs of these players as the day goes on Friday before that first pitch of the season.
Well, there's no question these guys are anxious. They're not going to sleep real great on Thursday night as they just can't wait to get out there on the field. A lot of pomp and circumstance in that first game. Even though all these guys have played many a first game by now, it's still been a while since they played a meaningful game. Probably since last summer, since some of them played in front of a decent crowd and all that kind of stuff. So they will be anxious, nervous, and ready to go. And like all good teams, there's a lot of competition on this team. You know, even though you have a starting job, game one, there's a lot of good players on the bench. So, there's that competitiveness, that competition's ready to go.
Ronnie, injuries are a part of any sport. LSU perhaps bitten by the injury bug a little more here in the preseason than you'd like it to be, not just with the major injuries that we've heard about with Bryce Jordan out for the year and an announcement on Thursday about the status of Greg Dykeman, but there's some sprained ankles, some pulled hamstrings. I mean, is it a little bit more, or is it just get more attention now because of social media?
Yeah, I definitely think it's because you get more attention because of the coverage is off the charts from what it used to be. You've got Duplantis in center, who his arm hasn't been very good. He's had somewhat of a tender arm. We haven't even talked much about that, but, I mean, that's something to keep an eye on. Not that LSU's really been known for having outfielders with tremendous arms under Paul Menneri, but he's got an arm that he's barely going to be able to hit the cutoff. And then you've got a situation where Jordan Romero's got a banged-up shoulder and a knee, who's pretty much going to be the DH, who's expected to be the backup catcher, but I don't know that he's healthy enough right now to even do that. And then you've got Chris Reed, who took a ball off the ankle in a squad scrimmage. You've got other guys with pulled hamstrings. This is a little bit of a mash unit over there at the box.
Yeah, so look, it's going to be a special weekend with Army and Air Force coming to town. We know Paul Menneri used to coach at Air Force. A lot of military appreciation, military recognition. So what was going to be a special weekend anyway has got a little extra flair in it.
Yeah, it's anytime you get to play against an Army, Navy, Air Force, whatever, that there's a little extra juice, and LSU will get a chance to play against two of them, Army and Air Force. And if you don't have a ticket, it's a beautiful day on Friday. It's a noon game between Army and Air Force. It's absolutely free going out and check it out. I'll tell you, I was recruited out of high school by the Navy, Army, and Air Force for football. And then I was dropped from being recruited once they got a copy of my transcripts. So I can respect and appreciate those guys that that put in the coursework, but then also put their life on the line once they get out of the service, out of the academy.
And Ronnie, I think it's been a real cool thing what Tulane and LSU have done here with swapping the Saturday opponents to give, you know, Army and Air Force a chance to play in New Orleans against Tulane, in Baton Rouge against LSU, and the fans at both stadiums to see two military academy schools play ball. Really nice move about a month or two ago when the coaches agreed to do that.
And, you know, it may be the beginning of something we see happen a little more often, Tommy, not just with the military, but if you're a, you know, USC or UCLA or a school from outside of the South that's taking a road trip down, that you don't get a Notre Dame or somebody you just don't get to see too much, an Arizona State or something like that, why not play two games against LSU and one game against UL or against Tulane, or do the same thing with UL, since the I-10 is just an easy hour drive? It's maybe something we might see more of in the future.
I think you're hitting the nail on the head there. We could see that because it's good for a lot of reasons, whether it's in Lafayette, New Orleans, or Baton Rouge. And, hey, it's all about more baseball and good stuff. Ronnie Rand, Sports Shorts Radio, Sports Shorts TV, we're going to get you to tell us about that in a few minutes. But first, Ronnie, a special event in Baton Rouge on Thursday night at the Walk-Ons of Burbank, the Glory Road Tour. Part of the Louisiana Sports Hall of Fame Foundation. Tell us what's happening Thursday night and the fact that people can still get a ticket if they want to go.
Yeah, it's a great event. The Glory Road Tour was stop number 4 of 6 across the state of Louisiana, thanks to the folks at Walk-Ons providing food and drink and a great venue. And so it's only $75. You can come at the door or you can go online to lasportshall.com. That's lasportshall.com/purchase. And you can get the tickets online, table, whatever the case may be. Got the tickets left. And it's from 6 until 8 p.m. Thursday, February 16th. And it's 6 to 8 p.m. And, you know, it's all you can eat, food and drink. There'll be some great silent auction items, raffle items, live auction items. But a chance to get up close and personal. And also hear from, with our panel discussion, the likes of Skip Bertman, Tommy Hodson, Jimmy Taylor is going to be there filling in for Dale Brown. Dale Brown had a eulogy he's got to go give out of state from an old friend. So Jimmy Taylor is going to be filling in the pro football Hall of Famer. But then we've got Yvette Girard, Jim Hawthorne, Ben McDonald, Rudy Macklin, and others that will be in attendance, and we'll also hear from them. It's going to be a great evening. The weather's supposed to be perfect. So come on out, support a good cause, Louisiana Sports Hall of Fame.
All right, Ronnie, before you go, tell us about Sports Shorts TV and Sports Shorts Radio.
Best Sports Shorts TV right here in Pelican, always. Mondays at 9, Tuesdays at 8, and the replays on Thursday night as well. We had Dan Canterbury of LSU and Southern on our show, along with LSU baseball assistant coach Nolan Kane. So if you missed it, check it out this Thursday in the replay. And then also Sports Shorts Radio Mondays from 6 until 8 on ESPN Radio 104.5, 104.9 in Baton Rouge.
All right, Ronnie, as always, we appreciate it.
Thanks, fellas. Have a great night.
All right. We'll talk to you again soon. Mr. Rance talking a little baseball. He's kind of been there and done that, huh?
Yep.
All right. We're going to take a little break. We'll come back, keep kicking it around with Jordy Hultberg. I'm Tommy Kreiss, and this is Tigers Roar on Pelican Sports TV, Baton Rouge, Lafayette, New Orleans, all over the world on the internet at pelicansportstv.com. Stay with us.
Experience what the Baton Rouge International School can offer your children. Now welcoming displaced students for short and long-term stability.
Acord Eye Clinic Vision Source is located on Perkins Road in Baton Rouge, offering full-service optical and lab work. Dr. Shonda Acord and the professionally trained staff pride themselves on service, complete eye exams, help with contact lenses, and selection of frames featuring Silhouette, Gucci, Jimmy Choo, and all the top lines. State-of-the-art equipment including OptiMap, which digitally photographs your retina. Call Acord Eye Clinic for an appointment, 225-767-3937. That's 225-767-3937. Visit the website visionsource-br.com. All patients of all ages are welcome. Acord Eye Clinic, Vision Source.
Hello, my name is Debbie. Welcome to Debbie's Bridal, A Formal Affair. Craven. I work at Debbie's Bridal, and she makes your dreams come true.
Veterinary Hospital is a full-service veterinary hospital committed to your pet's health. We offer advanced diagnostic and therapeutic medical services, laser surgery, dog and cat diets, and treats, along with stress-free boarding. Dr. Ritchie sees patients for routine checkups to keep your loved ones happy, also advanced medical and surgical cases. We have separate condos for cat boarding and large climate-controlled canine boarding. Our boarding dogs get to have fun in a very large play yard several times a day. Laser therapy is a service that we offer to heal wounds and help our patients that suffer from chronic pain. Laser therapy is a wonderful adjunct treatment for neurologic and arthritic pain with no side effects. Your pets are family members and deserve the best and highest quality of care. Dr. Ritchie and his staff greatly respect the human-animal bond and are committed to exceeding your expectations. Cypress Lake Apartments are conveniently located off Segan Lane in Baton Rouge. Come see this community, which has many amenities including swimming pools, fitness room, playground, and much more. Beautiful views of Cypress Lake. 1, 2, 3-bedroom apartments are available. Stop by and see Cypress Lake Apartments. Give them a call at 225-293-6789 or visit online cypresslake-apartments.net.
Since 1986, the family dental practice of Dr. Farrell Frugier, with state-of-the-art building and technology and our highly trained staff, have been dedicated to providing care and treatment to our patients of all ages. The experience and advanced training in cosmetic and restorative dentistry, TMJ, and treatment of snoring and sleep apnea allows Dr. Frugier to assist you in achieving the best in dental health. Call us today at 225-292-9700 to schedule your initial evaluation, because we know how to make you smile.
With Tigers Roar here on Pelican Sports TV. And like we like to do, we want to tell you about Tremonti's Meat and Seafood over there on Jefferson Highway, just down from Parkview Baptist Church and School. The lunch specials, the rotisserie chickens, the rotisserie ribs, the meat case, the steaks, the meat, the seafood, all the seafood for Lent coming up. They've got boiled crawfish every evening. You just call, make sure they got enough for you. Tremonti's.com has all the information, the catering, everything that you need. 225-751-7665 is the phone number. Call Mike and the staff at Tremonti's Meat and Seafood, Tremonti's.com. High-end spirits, wines, ice chests, grills. They got the sprinkle spice, the sauce you put on everything. I'm a big, big fan of that, and I've turned many people on to that. So you need to check them out. The lunch specials in the evening, the boiled crawfish. You having a crawfish boil? They can cater it, take care of that for you. Tremonti's.com, the website has tons of information, and the phone number 225-751-7665. Tremonti's Meat and Seafood. Go to see Mike and the staff. Tell them you heard us talking about it on Tigers Roar TV. Well, this is a big weekend coming up in New Orleans, because we've got the opening of the Mardi Gras season, which is always fun, and the NBA All-Star Game brings all of its marquee stars, all the owners, fans from all over the country. Third time the All-Star Game has been in New Orleans in the last 12 or so years, and it is there again as we have the All-Star Weekend. Lots of activities and festivities throughout the weekend, culminating with the game. The All-Star Game in New Orleans, Anthony Davis of the Pelicans is a starter for the Western Conference. If he has a big game, very good chance that he would be named most valuable player. But it's the Stars against the Stars, and it'll take place in the Crescent City this coming weekend. And we do have a special feature for you to let you get a little more feel for what's going to happen. Again, Mardi Gras is going to be down there. You might want to have a little patience with the traffic in the Crescent City this weekend. I mean, you probably have to do that all the time, but maybe so even more now with Mardi Gras beginning and the NBA All-Star Game. Here's a quick preview of the All-Star Weekend in New Orleans.
The Rising Stars Challenge rosters were released today from Team USA, Devin Booker and Malcolm Brogdon, Marquise Chris, Brandon Ingram, Frank the Tank, Jahlil Okafor, D'Angelo Russell, Jonathan Simmons, the aforementioned Spur, Carl Anthony Towns, and Miles Turner, and an interesting world squad as well, led by Joel Embiid.
The bomb.
Dante Exum, Buddy Hield, Nikola Jokic, Trey Lyles, Emmanuel Mudiay, Jamal Murray. Well, Denver Nuggets well represented.
The world squad got 5 7-foot point guards.
It's a big, big team, by the way. DeMontis Sabonis and Dario.
That's a good squad, man.
Right, man. Group. I wouldn't mind seeing him twice in that same weekend. That'll blow his minutes restriction, of course.
Yeah.
I mean, I think we'd be.
They're not back to back. They're not back to back.
It's not back to back.
And this is where not having the center position on the All-Star ballot hurts you, because, you know, really, if the center position was on the All-Star, you got some real guys at the center spot that can play.
These guys are all going to be on the same team, sharing court space with each other. The world team is going to be huge, man, by the way.
And the thing about these guys, and we were talking about this before, remember, the NBA game, the half court is much bigger now, right? Because back in the day, you didn't guard 28, 30. You didn't have to.
Right.
Now you got to be able to play in space.
He's aged out of the Rising Stars Challenge game. There's the roster
For
the American team, like anytime Carl Anthony Towns takes the floor, NBA game, Rising Stars game, whatever it is, that's good stuff.
Yeah, and he'll be out there playing to win. You guarantee yourself that. There will be no let-up in Carl Anthony Towns in the Rising Stars Challenge. And you talk about guys who project to the big game. I would guess that he'll get there about as fast as anybody else in this Rising Stars game. He and Embiid definitely will be candidates.
February 17th, 9 Eastern time, sharp, the BBVA Compass Rising Stars Challenge. Saturday night, State Farm All-Stars Saturday night, you're dunking, you're three-point shooting, you're skilling, which is not a word. And Sunday, the 66th NBA All-Star Game at 8 Eastern time, exclusively on TNT.
All right, again, going to be a big, big weekend in New Orleans with Mardi Gras beginning. It's not the biggest weekend of Mardi Gras, but still a lot of fun, a lot of activity. And then, of course, the All-Star Weekend. So there's going to be a lot going on. Again, if they're encouraging people to take cabs, Uber and Lyft and carpool and do all of that, it's going to be a little hectic, probably more hectic than normal down there in the Crescent City. So we hope all of that goes well, and we hope everybody enjoys the beginning of Mardi Gras and, of course, the NBA All-Star Game. All right, as we put a wrap on a few things on this week's edition of Tigers Roar, the top story that came out Wednesday afternoon, Arden Key, outside linebacker, defensive end for LSU football. It's been announced he'll take a leave of absence for personal reasons. Coach Orgeron has asked to respect his privacy on this personal matter, as he is will return to the team at an appropriate time. Indications are he's going to stay in school. Indications are he hasn't left the team, hasn't left the program. He's got a personal matter which he has to address. And Coach Orgeron, there's been discussion, and they're supporting Arden Key in this decision. That's all we know. A lot of stuff flying around there, but we'll leave that alone and just tell you what we do know is that spring practice doesn't start till Saturday, March 11. You know, don't know if he's back for then or not. We just have to wait and see. You'll have to wait for something to come from Arden Key or something to come from the LSU communications office. And then a little bit earlier this week, I wasn't surprised by the announcement, perhaps a little surprised by the timing. Quarterback Brandon Harris has announced he has left the LSU football program. He will finish up his school stuff, finish up and get his degree, and then seek to continue his playing career somewhere else. You see his stats up on the screen with his career at LSU, and he's going to go elsewhere. And I say I wasn't surprised that he left, Because as Brian Lazar pointed out, when Danny Etlin took over, he never saw another snap. It looks like LSU is Danny Etlin's the quarterback. I just didn't know if with the new offensive coordinator, Matt Canada, he might not want to go through spring practice with the quote-unquote open competition at the quarterback position, and then maybe he convinces the coach that, you know, he's the guy. But that didn't happen, so maybe it's good for two reasons. One, he can look around, and Brandon Harris may have an option or two as to where he can go. And then number two, for the important part to the LSU football side of things, is he's not going to be eating up any reps in the 15 spring practices. The other backup quarterbacks behind Etlin will get those reps, get that experience, get that, you know, action under the gun, pressure, all that good stuff, and maybe that helps them make themselves better, which then makes the team better. So you try to find the silver lining. And then it's kind of the same thing with Arden Key. They know what he can do. They know his skill set. They know what he's capable of. So now other people in those positions will get those reps in spring. Yeah, I am trying to find a silver lining because that's all you can do there. If they're not going to be there, they're not going to be there. Harris has moved on, and Key has the temporary leave from the team. And then also we heard tonight from Tommy Robinson and Mickey Joseph, the two new members of the coaching staff that Ed Orgeron has, and it's all about recruiting. And, you know, LSU has got to get the recruiting going in the right direction. Tommy Robinson is the recruiting director, and he will cover the Houston area, and there's a plethora of talent in the Houston area. And then, of course, Mickey Joseph, who played at Shaw High School in New Orleans, coached down in the city. He knows the people down there. They know him. And Mickey Joseph will be the wide receivers coach and recruit and be primarily responsible for recruiting in the New Orleans area. All right, I do want to remind you that this program, Tigers Roar, and other programs, we push them over to youtube.com/Pelican Broadcasting, where you can watch them in at your convenience. You can get sports shorts, you can get Tigers Roar, you can get the post game at your convenience, youtube.com/Pelican Broadcasting. Lots of other good stuff coming on our radio end and on our television end, all here at Pelican Broadcasting. If you haven't liked the Facebook page yet, please do so. The Facebook page is Pelican Broadcasting. Twitter account, at Pelican Sports. I already mentioned the YouTube page, and of course, TuneIn.com. On that app, you just search for WUBR. Or if you have the computer, TuneIn.com, WUBR, and you'll get the radio station. So appreciate that. Again, original airing of this program, Wednesday nights. If you're catching it Thursday, Friday, Saturday, or on YouTube, you obviously have a rebroadcast going. But we appreciate that. I want to thank Chris Ordy with the LSU Law School Barrister Bowl. That's this Saturday at Memorial Stadium, 12:30 kickoff, if you want to check it off. Thanks to Ronnie Rance. Thanks to Brian Lazar. On behalf of everybody at Pelican Broadcasting, it takes a lot of people to put this thing together. We appreciate them, and we appreciate you watching. I'm Tommy Chrisand. Spread the roar. Tigers roar.
Injured in an accident and you won your case, we can get you your cash fast.
I called Penn Funding and had my money fast.
If you're a victim of an accident, bad drug case, or any other legal settlement, but Penn Funding can get you paid in one lump sum.
Instead of my small monthly payments, Penn Funding got me my money when I needed it the most.
Turn your small monthly settlement payments into one large cash payoff right now. If your case is settled, you qualify. And no one can get your money faster than Penn Funding. There's no risk, obligation, or out-of-pocket cost when you make this life-changing call.
I called, answered the questions, and received my cash payoff quickly.
Need cash for your children? To fix your car, pay the bills. If your case is settled and you're a victim of an accident, bad drug case, or any other legal settlement, it's your money. Call Penn Funding now.
Call 800-825-1325, 800-825-1325.